G'day all, welcome to the second part of the Zero Array tutorial. This time we're going to go through coding what we outlined in the tutorial before. And yeah, let's see how we go. Okay, so I've set up a C++ front end here. This one's a little different from usual, but I think this is a much neater way to do it. For a start, I've put in a header, the zeroArray.h header. And that's over here, and it's pretty standard really. It's just got the guard at the top so we don't include our function millions of times. And then we've got the prototype for our assembly function just here, exactly the same as it would appear in our main.cpp, but yeah, sitting in a header, so that's a neater place to put it. And beside that I've got zeroArray.asm, which at the moment has nothing in it much, except for a couple of comments to describe what it is that we're going to do. Yeah, let's go through our main.cpp. So, first of all, we've got a count variable. Then the next line I've asked Windows to kindly spare us some RAM. So it'll give us 1024 characters. We should be checking if we ran out of RAM, but I don't know. Can't be bothered. But the next thing that we do is set every character in that array to some random character using rand here that I got from stdlib.h. That's just to make sure that we are actually setting something to zero. So we print out the initial values too, just to make sure that there's something in that array. And then we call our zero array procedure, and hopefully when we print out the values again we'll see that they're all set to zero. Finally, as per usual, I've got my get to prevent the window from closing. You wouldn't need that, of course, but we've got it here. And we free our memory, even though we're about to shut down, and Windows will be smart enough to free it for us. And yeah, that's the front end. And we've been through the header, so let's get straight on to the assembly side of things and code what we went through. Alrighty, so the first thing that we decided to do was check for zero or less. Let's have a look at how to do that. Comp edx 0, jump less or equal to finished. Alrighty, so this is checking for zero. So LE is less than or equal, so we're going to have our finished label down the bottom here. And there we go, we've stopped any silly mistakes by checking that we're given a positive number. Okay, the next thing that we said that we were going to do is, let's go on over, have a look, check for 1. So if we're given 1, we want to jump straight down to set final byte. Okay, comp edx and 1, compare edx to 1. Let me just check for 1, and JE set final byte. So we'll put set final byte right here, and all we want to do here is mov into a byte ptr rcx the value 0. We know that rcx is pointing to that byte since we pass a pointer, same as the first integer parameter, so RCX is going to point straight to whatever that byte was of this tiny array. Alrighty, so that's the two little housekeeping things. Let's have a look now what we said we were going to do next. Alright, we're going to set AX to 0, then we're going to save EDX to R8D, and then we're going to halve EDX. Let's have a look at how to do those. Obviously mov ax 0 is set ax to 0, 0, I'll put, just to indicate that we are doing two at once. Then we said we wanted to save r8d edx, to r8d, then we said we wanted to halve edx. So the easy way to halve a number, or indeed to divide by any power of 2, is shift right edx1, That's hard. It can't. Because. Because. We're using AX, not AL. Okay. Shift right EDX. Yep. Let's have a look what we said we'd do next. Oh, goody. We've got our loop. Okay. I'm just going to call it main loop. Force of habit, really. But, what we've got to do here is mov word ptr this time. We're setting words at once, rcx and ax. So this line is sets 2 bytes to 0 in the array. And the next thing that we want to do is add rcx 2. Move rcx to the next 2 bytes. Maybe I should zoom out a bit. There. Okay, and after we've added to RCX2, we want to decrement the counter, which is EDX, and we want to jump not zero to main loop. So this is decrement our counter, and this line is jump if we've more to set. Okay, that's looking pretty good. That should zero out an even number of bytes in the array, but we still have to tackle if there's an odd number. So we're up to just here in our diagram. Check if R8D was odd. How do we go about that? Well, it's very simple, really. All we've got to do is check if the rightmost bit is a 1. Okay, so R8D and 1. If we AND R8D with the value 1, if we end up with 0, then we know that R8D was an even number, so we can jump to finished. Okay, these two lines are check if there was an even number. If there was, we're done. And we'll jump to finished. If the number happened to be odd, we know that RCX is now pointing to the final byte, so we're right to fall through to the set final byte label, which should set that final odd byte. Okay, so I hope this line here makes sense. And R8D with 1. That's Boolean AND just there. If R8D happened to have 1 on the very end, then AND R8D is going to end up as equaling 1. If R8D happened to have a 0 on the very end, AND R8D is going to lead to R8D being set to 0. So, that checks if there was an even number. Okay, I'll just scroll around and see if I can spy anything silly that I've done. It all looks pretty good, so let's jump back to the C++ side of the world and hit F5 with our fingers crossed. Aha! Okay, so that's the output there from the second cout statement. Let's just scroll up a bit. And that was the original numbers in our array. So everything appears to have worked beautifully, but there's just one more thing that I'd really like to do, and that's if we go over to the assembly side of things and we put a breakpoint right at the start of our loop. If we hit F5, just to make sure that it's working, let's copy the address of the array from the registers window. Let's open up a memory window. Where are we, memory? And paste the address into there. Hit enter. Now we can keep a really close eye on exactly what's happening. Let's hit F11 to step through, and we'll see AX taking out 2 of these bytes at once. AX takes out 2, 2, bang, 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 off he goes. Beautiful. Everything seems to be working fine. Okay, folks, well, I hope that was interesting. And not too confusing. Thank you for listening.